Hey all, for those of you who are new here, I am Shannon Wells, a life and business coach for Christians, and I equip them with the tools they need to take their power back. So last night I was getting ready to go to bed and the Lord dropped a word in my spirit so strong and so powerful. I just had to get on and share with you all today. So for some of you, actually for a lot of you, the enemy thought you were dead. The enemy thought that you were out for the count. The enemy thought you were down. The enemy thought that he had you. And the enemy thought that he had you so strong that years have went by and you've been living in darkness, or you've been living in a wilderness season, or you've been living in the land of Egypt, you've been living in bondage, you have been living in a place in your life, right? You've been existing in a place in your life where you felt like, where is God in this season? Or maybe you haven't even been looking for God, right? God is just beginning to share with me right now that this is a season where the prodigals are coming home. The prodigals are coming home. And so the Lord began to share with me a word. I just kept hearing it last night over and over again. I just kept hearing the word awakening. I kept hearing the word awakening. I'm just saying that twice because it's so powerful, right? And he reminded me of the scripture that I have on my channel, and it's Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 4-5. And I want to read it to you today. And it says, "Again he said unto me, prophesy unto these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live." We are entering into a season like never before, where there is going to be a powerful awakening. And there's specifically going to be a powerful awakening among those that the enemy thought was dead, among those that the enemy thought he had, among those that we would classify as prodigals. Sons, we're going to see an awakening, a massive awakening amongst the body of Christ, specifically for those that the enemy thought he was dead. And God began to reveal to me last night that he had planted seeds in these individuals. He had planted seeds in these people a long, long time ago, some of them years ago, some of them decades ago, right? And it's gotten to the point where people have forgotten about them. People have thought that they were too far gone for the Lord to reach them. People have thought that these people were just written off for the kingdom of darkness. People have thought that these people are just written off as too worldly, right? They're too far gone for God, right? But I heard God say, with man it's impossible, but with God everything is possible, right? So we are coming into a season where there's going to be a massive awakening, and God has planted these seeds years ago, right? And the enemy thought that he could choke out the seeds that God has planted with weeds, but God says no, these seeds have been planted by vessels of God who have completely given their life to God specifically for the purpose of saving souls, right? These are seeds that have been planted a long time ago that God is beginning to wake up in these individuals. We are getting ready to experience a massive awakening. I just kept hearing that word. I keep hearing the word awakening, awakening, awakening. And God implanted my spirit, Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 4-5. There have been relatives that you guys have been praying over. There have been friends that you guys have been praying over. There have been situations, right? There have been experiences. There have just been things and people, right, that you guys have been praying over, and it's been years. And you guys have forgotten about these things. You guys have written these people off, right? But God is saying there's going to be a massive awakening. He's getting ready to breathe life into those things, people, and places that you thought were dead, that the enemy thought was dead. But God is saying not so. He's getting ready to breathe life into those areas. Amen, amen. I just keep hearing God just drop in my spirit, awakening, awakening, awakening. It's so beautiful. It almost brought me to tears last night just thinking about it. I had to come on and share it with you guys. And a quick word for those of you who have been emailing me, because I'm not able to respond back to everyone. I'm so sorry, but I'm trying to get to it. A lot of you have been emailing me about life coaching and business coaching. The links are down below, and I just want to remind you of that. If you are needing to find that link, it is down below. But I am so excited for God, what God is getting ready to do in this season. I see it happening already, where people who you never thought would turn to the Lord are turning to the Lord, where we see a massive awakening happening, and it's so beautiful. And I want you guys to pray for these people. I want you guys to pray for these people that God is sparking a light in their spirit, right? Do not, it is such a dangerous thing to be on the wrong side of God. It is such a dangerous thing to be against God, right? To speak against things that are of God, right? Because it's easy to see things and immediately write it off as not being God. But how do you know specifically if something is not God? You're supposed to test the spirit, right? We don't want to be the people who see someone turning to God and speaking against it and saying that it's not God, right? Because God looks like many different things. God shows up in people in many different ways, right? And so we want to pray before we speak out against someone, right? Because God could be working through someone, and God could be using someone in a way that you're not familiar with, in a way that doesn't look like religion, in a way that doesn't look like traditional church, right? But it could very well be God, right? So be careful to be careful of speaking out against things that may be God that doesn't look like what church or religion says is God, if that makes sense. So I just heard the Lord say that. So I wanted to leave that with you today. I'm so excited for what God is doing in this season, and I'll leave you with that today.